Hello everyone, my name is Prajakta Dhake and I am from Department of Zoology, KTHM College, Nashik. Today, I'll be taking a lecture for MSc Part 2, the semester is 3. The subject that I'll be dealing with today is Insect Physiology and it is the 17th chapter of this particular subject. What does this comprise? It comprises of endocrine systems, neurosecretory hormones, the chemistry, function and mechanisms of hormone action. We will also be studying about molting and juvenile hormone, chemistry and physiology, other peptides and steroid hormones. So today's topic that we are going to start with is the endocrines. This is the first lecture of this particular chapter. Let's begin. For understanding this, we need to first understand what is endocrine system. Endocrine system mainly comprises of the hormones. Okay. So now, what are hormones? Hormones are chemicals produced by an organism which circulate in the blood to regulate its long-term physiological, developmental, and behavioral activities. They complement the nervous system, which provide short-term coordination, and the activities of both these systems are closely linked. So, the nervous system, the activity of the nervous system and also of the endocrine system or hormonal system is going to be closely working with each other. Now let's begin with the chemical structure of certain hormones. Here today we'll be dealing with three types of hormones. The first one is going to be your molt. Apart from molting hormones and juvenile hormone, most known insect hormones are peptides. Some biogenic amines are also known to function as the hormones. Let's begin with the first hormone, which is molting hormone. Molting hormones are ichthyosteroids, which in immature insects are produced by prothoracic glands. In most insects, these glands secrete ichthyosone, but some larval lepidoptera are also known to secrete 3-dehydroichthyosone, which is converted to ichthyosone by enzymes in the hemolymph. Ichthyosone is a prohormone. It is converted to the active hormone, which is 20-hydroxyichthyosone. And where it is converted? It is converted into the fat body or say the epidermis. And who converts it or who aids in the conversion is cytochrome P450 enzyme. Clear? In honeybee, Apis, and in Heteroptera, the principal ichthyosteroid is Machisteron A. Okay. The insects cannot synthesize steroids. Consequently, sterols, usually cholesterol or a closely related structure, are essentially dietary constituents. So they have to take it, they do not produce it on their own, but they have to take it in the form of dietary supplement. Okay. Now moving on to the next hormone, which is juvenile hormone. Now juvenile hormone is sesquiterpene produced by corpora alata. Several slightly different forms known as JH0, JH1, JH2 and JH3, which contains 19, 18, 17 and 16 carbon atoms respectively, which means that JH0 is going to contain 19 carbon atoms, JH1 is going to contain 18 carbon atoms, and JH2 17, and JH3 is going to contain near about 16 carbon atoms, and all these have been isolated till the date. Juvenile hormone 3 is the form occurring in most of the insects. JH1 and JH2 are known primarily from Lepidoptera, and JH0 only from the Lepidopteran insects. Wandering stage larvae of mandioca and in ferret adult males of Hylophora, the corpora alata produces juvenile hormone acid that is subsequently converted to juvenile hormone in the imaginal disc and accessory sex glands respectively. In addition to JH3, the corpora alata of Cyclorhephus diptera secretes two related compounds, bisoproxide of JH3 and methyl farnesate, and it is possible that similar compounds are also produced by other insects. The fate or the function of these compounds are still unknown. Let's move on to another type of hormone, which is peptide hormones. Insects have many different peptide hormones. Some of them are given will be given later on. They are produced by the individual cells, mainly in the central nervous system and in the midgut epithelium. In some cases, as with the prothoracicotrophic hormone and adipokinetic hormone, their functions are well established. But the roles of many others remain obscure, even though they may have been shown experimentally to produce certain physiological effects. Peptide hormones with similar function in different insect species are often similar in size and amino acid sequence. Although differences do occur, there are conserved regions in which amino acid sequence are similar. The adipokinetic hormone illustrates this point. They are also closely similar to the hypertrihalosemic hormones, which are responsible for elevating trihalose levels in the hemolymph, and to the cardiac acceleratory hormones. In other cases, peptides that are functionally the same have different structure. For example, allostatin allostatin is found in orthopterid insects are structurally different from those so far identified Lepidoptera. When two hormones are similar in function, are present in the same species, so means that two hormones with similar functions are present in the same species, they may have similar compositions or may be different. For example, the different allostatins produced by Diploptera all have the same sequence: phenylalanine, glycine, leucine, and NH2 group attached to it at the C-terminal end, although other parts of their sequences differ. Larval Lepidoptera have two prothoracicotrophic hormones, one small, consisting of only 4 to 7 amino acids, and the other with 22 to 30 amino acid residues. The large hormone is a dimer, which means that a molecule composed of two similar units. Peptide hormones are derived from protein precursors, which are cleaved and modified post-translationally. And why are they modified? To produce the active peptide. Sometimes only a single active peptide is formed from one protein. This is the case with prothoracicotrophic hormone and adipokinetic hormone. In other instances, however, several different peptides are produced from single protein. The seven peptides with allostatin properties in Diplurioptera are all derived from the same protein. In Bombyx, a single precursor protein is the source of dipol's hormone and pheromone biosynthesis activating hormones, peptides with quite different function. Peptide hormones vary in the number of amino acid residues they contain. Some have as few as 8, but there are much larger also. Pheromone biosynthesis activating neuropeptide, which is PBAN, has 33 amino acid residues. Eclosion hormone has 62 residues, and Bursicon is a protein of 30 kilodaltons. And this was all from my side about the structure of hormones. In the next lecture, we'll be seeing endocrine organs. Thank you so much for listening.